Welcome back, everyone, to more The Witcher. Now, what spookiness awaits us in the House of Spook?
Our guests, never a good omen.
No. There are spoons.
Just as Raven wasn't lying. Spoons all over the place.
Ech. No. I guess we won't go that way. Now I'm just having a look-see around. Yeah, that just leads out. Oh man, Geralt, you're so overpowered right now. I can't even. Like, they have no chance. I mean, let's be honest.
Trying to tell me something.
Yeah, well, it's as usual, you'll have to beat me over the head pretty hard before it sinks in with me. So, you know, that's where we are. As per usual.
None shall sit and dine with you at your table. No spoon you have shall say to you. Never again shall you wish to spy your reflection in the mirror. Sounds like a curse, all right. Somebody's clearly obsessed. Regis mentioned the place might be cursed. Can't be a coincidence. Need to look around.
Yeah, man. What do you mean? Is that inside the house? I'm assuming it is. Just seems like it's in the house.
None shall sit and dine with you at your table.
Yep.
No spoon you have shall say to you. Never again shall you wish to spy your reflection in the mirror. What a pigsty. Need to search it thoroughly. Find a way to collect some white saliva. White's obsessed. Real collector. Thoroughbred. Spoon. Pretty ordinary. Maybe a little old. Spoon's incredible. The craftsmanship must have graced a rich man's table.
Ah. For a few days now, I've been having dizzy spells. I've never experienced anything like this before. If it carries on, although I can't stand witchcraft and sorcery, I'll have to visit a herbalist. The dizziness has not gone away. Worst of all, it's been joined by pain, so strong that at times I cannot see. I've been to the herbalist. A repulsive old crone looked at me like she had seen a monster. She gave me some cursed mixture that I have to drink twice a day. It's not helping at all. Today, like every day, I looked in the mirror and I was lost for words. I usually check that I don't have any wrinkles or bags under my eyes, but today, there are no wrinkles. But I'd rather that there were. I have hair growing on my breasts. It's horrible. It's got to be because of those damned herbs. I went to the herbalist to smash her face in, but her chambers were empty. She must have known about what happened to me and legged it. My family is starting to suspect something, although I'm cutting the hair back, which is growing back faster and faster. I've tried to put the idea out of my head, but I can't hold it back any longer. Maybe it wasn't the herbs that have led to this, but a curse placed upon me by an old beggar who I had to chase off one time. I have to find out. I want to hire someone who can find the herbalist. I cannot think. It is getting hard to write. Loneliness. No family. Eat? I want to eat. Not a good spoon. Empty spoons. Nothing. Eat. It hurts. Mirror. Lies. No. Ah!
Realized she was changing into a monster. Recorded it in her diary. Poignant. Smashed mirror. As if someone couldn't stand to look at themselves. The monster. Journal's author, maybe?
So we got some spoons. That's good. We need spoons.
No spoon you have shall sate you. Whatever lives here treated that literally. Still searching for the right spoon. Another spoon. Yep, just as normal as the last one.
I will search every spoon. Spoon key.
Spoon key. Sophisticated crafting. Tag bears a description. White's a true collector.
This certifies the item up for auction, an antique spoon key forged at the Christofferson and Sons workshop at 1210. Belongs to Smeagol Serkins. Andy Serkins, but Smeagol. Owner of the pheasantry.
White's obsessed. A real collector. Thoroughbred. Spoon. Pretty ordinary. Maybe a little old. Skeletons. Doubt they came here willingly. This have anything to do with the curse? None shall sit and dine with you at your table. It'd make sense. Right arm bit right off. Teeth all knocked out. Somebody tried to force feed him. No claw or fang marks. Probably choked to death.
Hmm.
Broken neck, indentation in the skull's lateral surface, smacked in the head with something heavy.
Dear Mr. Lavasseur, I know you track outlaws for pay. I have an unusual assignment for you. No doubt you wonder why I've drawn you out here and why we cannot meet in person. You see, in my present situation, any kind of meeting is very risky. No, not so much for me as for the person whom I meet. For I am afflicted by a curse, or, as I hope and why I've turned to you, the side effects of medicine given to me some time ago by herbalist. Soon after I visited this herbalist, she disappeared without trace. I desperately wish to understand my illness, so I wish to hire you to find her. When you do, learn as much from her as you can about the medicine she gave me. If my suffering is a result of her wickedness, then make her provide an antidote. I assure you, I have ample wealth and will reward you with no small part of it for your services. If it turns out my suffering is not the fault of the herbalist, please let her go. I will then have a different task for you, because this shall mean I am afflicted by a terrible curse which only the gods can cure. I believe it was cast upon me by a certain beggar who came by the manor while I was hosting a soiree for a few friends. If you can find that vagrant, I will pay you double. Sadly, all I remember of him is that he sold mirrors. I am aware this is not much to aid for your hunt, yet I trust in your considerable talents and wish you the best of luck. Marlene the Trastamara.
Woman's name scratched into this wooden spoon. Romantic.
Alright. I'm gonna save the game here. It's a treasure hunt. Doesn't matter then. What about, do I have a secondary quest? That's an old man, huh? Yeah, well.
Actually does seem like a White's Lair. Bit atypical, but still. Cauldron should be somewhere around here. Cauldron I was looking for. White's not particularly tidy. Table's set. White, who lives here, is getting ready for some sort of feast. White that lives here, definitely afflicted by a curse, and it's been trying desperately to lift it. Another spoon. Yep, just as normal as the last one.
You say that, Geralt, but you don't understand. You just don't. We gotta examine every spoon that there is, ever has been, and stuff. Now we're gonna go this way.
White's obsessed. Real collector. Thoroughbred. Spoon. Pretty ordinary. Maybe a little old. Another spoon. Yep. Just as normal as the last one.
Monstrous curses in the description.
White's obsessed. Real collector. Thoroughbred. Thousands of them here. White's been a collector for years. Spoon. Pretty ordinary. Maybe a little old.
What about the spoon key?
Another spoon. Yep, just as normal as the last one.
What? Come on. Can't do this to me. There we go. Little ambiance. Alright.
Cauldron's empty, unfortunately. We just need some brew. Afraid he won't get that. No choice but to hide and wait for the saliva glands and their bearer. Need a spot that'll let me observe the cauldron.
In the closet, of course. Duh. We'll see how it is. What happens? Then she's in there. Sneaky. I could imagine that's how it happens. She just puts her hand on the shoulders.
Hello. How do you do?
Look at a crown of spoons. Let's try and lift the curse. You know. Mercy. Have mercy on the poor wizened child. Christ. Geralt. Yes, it is beautiful! Honda, honda, honda.
I'm not gonna hurt you. Wanna help? I've seen the words of the curse on the walls. Think I know how to lift it.
Wait, we do? Oh, I'll lead with her.
Tried to bring folk here, convince them to sit at the table with you, right? Well, I'm gonna be your guest now. Your willing guest. Just need a bit for Regis. And now we'll tend to you.
Oh, the dog bark.
Need to get this right. Words of the curse were, none shall sit and dine with you at your table. No spoon you have shall sate you. Never again shall you wish to spy your reflection in the mirror.
Okay, wait, so no one should sit at her table. Right, so we sat at her table. No spoon.
Need to get this right.
Words of shall sate you.
None shall sit and dine with you at your table. No spoon you have shall sate you. Never again shall you wish to spy your reflection in the mirror.
I don't know if that's gonna. No spoon shall sate you. Eat with spoons? Shit, I suck at puzzles. Should we swap some spoons? No spoon she has. We'll sate her. Or let's eat not using spoons. I don't know. Let's
been
swap them.
For the right spoon for years, right? But curses can be tricky. The key to this one just might be that you can't eat with your own spoon. That's why we've swapped. This isn't right. I missed something? Listen, gonna stand up real slow. Gotta search the house again. Sit tight, I'll be right back. Calm down. Damn it, didn't work. Ate that vile stuff for nothing.
Let's try and figure this out, right? It could also be not eating with spoons at all. You know, no spoon shall sate you. Whatever. I don't think it was the obvious just, you know, just eat with the spoons. Eat with the spoons. Out of here. Check, 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 check. Check it, check it, check.
We can't use spoons. No, that won't work. You've been looking for a spoon that would feed you, but there's no such spoon. We need to eat without
There spoons. Are no spoons. Yeah, there we go. My gut instinct was that, but I don't know, man. I just don't know. It made too much sense.
Think it worked. Just not quite like I expected. Need to see what happened to the white. Won't be hard to find given its stench.
She's probably a beautiful maiden now, and we will go bang. We'll bang, okay? never gets old. Hey. Whee! There we go. Hey! No, you don't. So where'd she go? Ah, I see.
Shh, easy. Not gonna hurt you.
Eat. I must eat.
I'll take you someplace safe.
Yeah, I mean, I think we gotta lift the curse on these woods. I mean, they're too foggy. A Corvo Bianco. Stay at my house, why don't you?
So I took her by the hand and led her here. Seemed the only sensible place for her.
You did the right thing, sir. She should recover quickly here. Don't worry, sir. I shall see to everything.
She we can't just...
here and in good hands. She'll soon be back on her feet.
Might actually take a while. She hadn't eaten anything in over 100 years when I found her.
Horrid. Whatever brought this about?
Told me her story on the way here. Her name's Marlena. She was once the very beautiful and proud heiress to the Trastamara estate. One evening, when she was holding a banquet for friends, a beggar came to her gate seeking alms. He had a bowl and a spoon with him. He sat outside her fence and waited.
I've heard of the custom. An ancient rite of hospitality that obliges one to give food and drink to such a guest lest he depart hungry. To neglect the custom is to bring great misfortune down upon oneself.
Marlena didn't care a whit for the old customs. She drove the man off, saying she'd rather feed the leftovers from her feast to her dogs than to give the beggar anything. The beggar then broke his spoon, cast a curse. She was beautiful, so he said she'd never wish to look at herself in the mirror again. Since she adored feasts, he swore no one would ever wish to sit and dine with her. And as she even refused him the crumbs from her table, he swore she'd never find a spoon in the world that would sate her hunger.
A harsh punishment. I imagine lifting the curse was hardly simple.
Curses are tricky. They play on irony.
Is he a witcher in training? I'm gonna teach him my shit.
Spent decades looking for a way to lift it. Transformed into a white, she stole spoons and lured folk into her home, trying each time to get them to dine with her. Didn't work.
So what did?
Someone had to sit down and share a meal with her, of their own free will. They had to eat without using spoons, and make her look at her reflection.
That's it? That was all it required?
Simplest solutions are sometimes the last that come to mind. Besides, when you're a white, it's Pretty damn hard to find willing human company for a feast.
I imagine so. But most importantly, it is now over. Please, don't worry. She will be in good hands here.
Thanks. Gotta get back to my business now. See you soon.
I thank you. So tasty. Oh, so good.
Major Dumbo! He almost trapped me. Aye, that was close. I almost died. Alright, let's sleep this toxicity off. Yeah. Beautiful, beautiful. See, look at this. Getting all these bonuses. Can't even stop me. Probably. What's this? Huh. My sword. I don't know. We'll keep this on hand. Do we want to even? I don't know, maybe. Do I usually save these stupid swords? I usually don't. I don't know why I am. Good question. We're missing one trophy from something. Ah, beautiful. Covo Bianco. Beautiful. Alright, guys. I think, I think I'll take this time to, end the episode. So, I want to say thanks for watching, guys, and tune into the next episode.